For that purpose, I'm very proud and happy to invite to the stage the award-winning chef, Nir Zook. He has opened numerous restaurants, he's written cookbooks, he's a TV star, and he's also a consultant for food tech companies. Nir, please come to the stage.
Excited. I'm going to do salmon two ways. I was planning on many ways, but so many people around here, so only two and only we're going to taste.
Okay.
One is going to be sauteed and the other one is a ceviche, and I'm going to make lamb chops.
Wow, this sounds exciting, but these are not your everyday salmon and lamb chops, and we'll talk about this in a minute. In the meantime, I would like to invite to the stage the beautiful and amazing Michal Ansky.
Woo!
She is a master gastronomist, master taster. She has a degree in the history of food, and she teaches hands-on students how to connect between food to nutrition and culinary expertise. Michal.
Hello, everyone. Hello, Noga.
Hello.
So, well, we have this mission of creating a more sustainable and healthier food industry, and plant-based food is a huge part of that. But it's been going through a very tough year in the past few months or year, if you like. What's your take on that? Where did we go wrong?
I believe that there's two things to be done. The first one is to maintain a dialogue, a constant dialogue, between the good people of the food tech ecosystem, you guys. They're really good people. When they speak about what they're doing, they touch the heart. It's a different ecosystem than any other techs in the world.
Agreed.
And us, the culinary world, which I represent here today as a judge of MasterChef, as a person who still crave food, which is starting to be a rare human being kind of notion. So chefs, farmers, foodies, food enthusiasts, talk to us. Have this dialogue with us. And the second thing, which is even more important, is please, please make the new food taste good. I know it sounds simple and easy, but it's a really hard task to achieve. A lot of people here in the audience know that. So if we put these two together, we realize that it wouldn't taste good if there wouldn't be a dialogue, and there wouldn't be dialogue if it wouldn't taste good. So good luck with that.
Thank you. And I think maybe the best commentators on that could be the people behind these innovations. So for that purpose, I'd like to invite Ofek Ron, CEO and founder of Plantish, the first alternative salmon that actually tastes, grills, and cooks like real salmon. Hey, Ofek.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Great being here, everyone. Good morning.
Hello, Ofek. You're making salmon, right?
That's correct.
Okay, from all the fish in the ocean, why salmon?
Okay, it's a great question. Salmon is the most popular fish in the planet. The demand for salmon is great. However, salmon often contains mercury, antibiotics, and microplastic, and is produced unsustainably. Our salmon is more sustainable, more healthy, both for the planet and for the people. And that's why we created salmon.
That's amazing. But Ofek, price is a big deal for food tech in general. And how choosing salmon makes that a difference?
So salmon is super expensive. If you go down the street here, you will find salmon in $40 per kilo per fresh salmon.
In Tel Aviv, more.
Yes. Now, we use the same ingredients, the same family of ingredients that other alt proteins companies are using to create beef burgers or chicken. But we do salmon when the price target is way higher, and that's why we can already compete with the conventional salmon but bring a better experience for everyone.
Great answer. Thank you.
Thank you.
But we have more than salmon here, so this is maybe the right time to invite to the stage Professor Yaakov Nahmias. He is the president and founder of formerly known Future Meat and now to be known Believer. Kobe, please come to the stage.
Thank you, Noah. Good morning, our crowd.
Kobe, you're such a veteran entrepreneur in this space, and you know it pretty well. So give us a hint. Why and how are you doing your newest endeavor, Moon Steak, a bit different?
So we spoke before about, why is the plant-based category going down, right? And there are two major problems. The first one is that it doesn't taste good. I have five kids at home. I'm a scientist, so I'm running experiments on them all the time. They don't like it. They simply don't like the burgers. They don't like the nuggets. They don't taste real. So taste is number one. But the second thing is that nuggets are boring. You know, we need to go beyond that. They want pulque. They want a chicken drumstick. You know, my wife and I want some lamb chops that Nir is cooking for us. My boy wants a T-bone steak. So we need to bring in the 2.0 revolution for food tech. And this is why I founded Moon Steak Technologies.
That's great, but I want to ask you even a harder question. I'm sure you'll agree with me when I say that food doesn't exist without a content, without a context. So when we talk about technology, when we deal with technology, don't you forget about the ethos? I know you have a very good story, I just heard it, but what about the memories, the identity, the lust? Where does that exist in the future meat?
You have to answer it because you're going to taste our lamb chops for the first time on stage.
Nir, are you ready for us?
The question is, are you ready for me?
But I'll give you the answer for me.
Yeah.
As a dad of five little kids, I am spending the morning and figuring out what are they going to eat for breakfast, what are they going to have for lunch. And then when I'm making Shabbat dinner, is my mom going to eat it and she's going to like it or not? So if I don't do that, if I don't cross the barrier to, you know, an emotional engagement with the dish, I'm doing something wrong. This is what, you know, being Jewish is all about. This is what, you know, family values are all about. You're cooking and you're making products for your kids and for your family. So let's try to make that happen.
Thank you, Kobe. Thank you.
300%.
This made me so much more enthusiastic to taste what you have here. So I think Nir is done, so let's step over there and see what he has prepared for us.
Okay.
Are you enjoying the cooking? How does it feel to cook your future?
Listen, do I look enjoying?
Of course I'm
enjoying.
Yeah, you look happy.
2 years ago when Ofek came to me, I thought, okay, I'm going to meet with him for 5 minutes and he's going to leave and I'm going to go back to my salmon. And then he was talking about the ocean and so passionate about what he's doing that I said, okay, this is a guy that his head and heart are in the right place. I'm excited. And ever since, I started, you know, visiting this world of future food.
Yeah. And vegan entrepreneurs.
Yes. You know, for me as a chef, you know, Cordelia for so many years, you know, when we had vegan customers, someone used to come to the kitchen and say, oh, they're here again. And now it's a different world for me. I'm making whole dinners, only vegan food, plant-based, mainly, you know, legumes and vegetables, and you're going to taste in a second. Ceviche made of salmon, the salmon steaks that we made here with some tomatoes and basil. There are so many applications. I made only two because of the short time. And now I'm plating the lamb chops over the greens.
And lamb chops. Wow. It looks exactly the same.
Well,
only the bone is what? It's wood?
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Made of wood.
Completely recyclable.
The interesting thing is mainly the fat, I think, around, that is very unusual, that you can enjoy the smell of lamb. If you smell the pan here, With the rosemary, you have some lamb.
It smells like lamb.
As well as the salmon that feels like salmon that came out of the ocean. So, Michal, grab a fork.
Yeah, there's a lot of international crowd. What I do for a living is I taste. I taste food and I tell whether it's good or not. So I'm going to do it right now.
You can look at the flakiness of the fish just as a regular salmon that you would buy in a fish shop. Super exciting.
Okay, guys, is bleeding a little. We have to taste. Come on.
Noga, please join me.
I will.
Ofek. Mi she'ochel levad.
No?
Look at the texture. It has flakes. Do you see it?
This is actually the first time in 2 years that we are doing this on stage. For 2 years, we are standing in the lab and tasting and tasting and tasting, and I'm proud of you.
May I start? Ofek, zeptata. It's really good. Really, I'm not even thinking about salmon. I'm just enjoying my bite. Mm. It tastes good, the flakes, the soft texture, it's friendly. It feels like a new kind of food, and this is what I'm looking for when I'm eating these sort of future foods, that I feel like I can crave it, I feel like I can enjoy it, and I'm really, like, it makes my finger want to move and try and push Chef Zook away and try to work with it myself. I really believe there's a future, not only in the ocean, for your salmon, and I'm really excited to taste it. Good luck.
Thank you so much.
You have to take a bite of the lamb chop, and then we have to clear the stage because
I'm going to take a bite.
Yeah, you chose a beautiful one.
Do you see the fat? That's amazing.
It's crazy. You need to try the fat.
Oh my God. No.
Kobe, that's amazing. Wow.
No, I want to explain. It tastes like lamb. It's not similar. It's almost exactly.
Where are our friends from Abu Dhabi? You need to say whether it's lamb or not.
And the most interesting thing here is the fat, the way it feels in my mouth. It's juicy. And this is really, when we speak about food, okay, we want to crave it. We want to eat. You know, when you're saying lamb chops, you want to hold those lamb chops and bite them. It's still politically correct. And I have this experience when I eat it. Thank you.
Ofek, Nir, Michal.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you very much.